Hey guys, here's another battle report for you. This is a 2,000 point game I played the other day against my buddy Elliot's Ogre Kingdoms. I've done a report with these ogres in it before, but this is a different list he was using to take advantage of some cool rules in 8th edition. Sorry I haven't been all too consistent with battle reports. I did play a couple games over the past couple of weeks, but every time I forgot my camera, sort of like magic. Although they were really good games and I would love to have reported them, I didn't actually get any pictures. One particularly was against Warriors of Chaos and was really close, really tight fought, and came down to a draw of about 60 points, which is pretty dang close. So anyway, on to this report. Here's this the setup. We got the little buildings, and some walls, and then there's a mysterious forest in the center. So that's the terrain, and I'll go over armies. So here's an overview of my opponent's army. Like I said, he's playing Ogre Kingdoms. He's got a couple big block units in there. He's got one unit of I believe 10 bulls, with full command and additional hand weapons. And in that unit, he's also got a battle standard bearer and his butcher. His butcher is actually the minotaur. It's sort of sitting in the middle of the unit. He's got a butcher model, but he hasn't put it together yet. So I lent him one of my own unpainted minotaurs to stand in for that. He's taking advantage of the monstrous infantry rule that the command always takes precedence in the front rank. So he can put his battle standard bearer and his butcher in the second rank without actually having any penalties to the unit. They still get the BSB bonus, and they are, of course, in range of the general, so they don't really need the leadership. He's also got a unit of 46 Knoblars, I believe, in a big block unit, a big block formation to try to hold up some of my bigger units. And then he's got a unit of a couple Iron Guts, I think 8 Iron Guts with command and the standard of discipline, and his general's in there, so he's leadership 10. He's got his Ogre Tyrant with a great weapon in with the Iron Guts, and then he's got 2 units of Lead Belchers on the flanks with Bellowers, and in the back there he's got a Gorger that, of course, is not actually in the back, it's just there for the picture, and that will be deployed later on. Here's my army. I took a little bit of a different approach to my previous armies. I took 2 big bus units of 40 gores. I pulled out all of my gores for this one. I was literally using every single gore model I had. So sorry for all of the masses of unpainted miniatures. So two units of 40 gores with additional hand weapon and full command. And then I've got a unit of 6 minotaurs with additional hand weapons. And then in there is my gore ball battle standard bearer. He's got gnarled hide and the brass cleaver, so he's got a pretty good armor save, and he dishes out a buttload of attacks in close combat. And then on top of that, I have a 2 level 1 Bray Shamans, one with the Dispel Scroll, one with the Hearthstone. And then I have my Beast Lord with the Talisman of Preservation and the Steel Claws, so he's not too shabby. Oh, and then also, it was pointed out to me in an earlier video that you actually do not get the minus 1 to hit penalty for shooting at lone characters anymore, which is strange because you still get it for skirmishers. So what I ended up doing was taking 2 units of 5 Ungor Raiders and just putting my Bray Shamans in there so that the Lead Belchers couldn't pick them off as easily. Now, the penalty for that is that if I lose a bunch of raiders and the unit runs away, I could just completely fail to rally because the unit is under 25%. But I figure that I'll just pull the characters out of there if it ever gets to that point. So here's the board after my first turn. I did win first turn, and I deployed, of course, my Hearthstone in the center there, and then 2 gore blocks on the other side. My general and the Bray Shamans are in the middle there, and those Ungor Raider units, they moved up. They're still in range of the Hearthstone, but I didn't want to get eaten by a gorger if that did show up on my board edge. And everything just sort of moved up my turn. Not a lot exciting happened. So in my opponent's turn, he moved up most of his units into the forest. He was expecting me to charge with my gore units, because if I charged into the forest, which we then found out was a poison thicket, so it was dangerous terrain, and made everyone inside it poisoned, gave them poison attacks. Really only hurt me because most of his guys were monstrous infantry and they were going to be taking dangerous terrain, moving through it most of the time anyway. So he moved up into the forest, and expected me to charge because if I charged and into the forest, I would lose steadfast. So what I did was I charged with the minotaurs onto the bull unit. He was beating me statically, but I figured that I could just do enough wounds to break that unit. And then I moved up with the gores on my right flank. They are not actually in combat with those iron guts. They're a couple inches away, waiting for the iron guts to charge them because I don't want to move into that forest and lose my steadfast bonus. So what ended up happening was the minotaurs did a ridiculous number of wounds, something like 17 wounds to the bull unit. And because he was in the forest, even though he had more ranks than me, he was not steadfast, and he broke the unit. I broke the unit. He lost both his battle standard bearer and his standard bearer, and but got away. I think what he should have definitely not run into the forest because that hurt his steadfast. So, but I don't think he was used to having a unit with this many ranks. So here you can see in my opponent's turn, he rallied the fleeing bull unit, and he moved up with his lead belchers and charged the gores with the iron guts. The iron guts did an enormous number of wounds to the gores. However, I was steadfast, and my general was just in that other gore unit, so they ended up not breaking. He opened up with the lead belchers on the gore unit on the left there, and only did a couple of wounds, only did one or two wounds, so that didn't really do much. And then the other ones marched, so they didn't fire, but they're in perfect range to fire at the Ungor raiders and try to kill some of my shamans, which is really what I don't want to happen. So what did happen is that my minotaurs charged the bulls again. They killed the butcher and most of the unit and ended up breaking them, but failing to run them down again. But he is below 25% now, so he does need double ones to rally. And then I moved the gore unit over to face the lead belchers, to basically try to scare them off. If they didn't run away, then they could continue to fire at my wizards. Unfortunately, one of my Bray Shamans, who's in the forest right now, miscast and got the four. He didn't kill himself, but he did wipe out his entire Ungor Raider unit. He passed the leadership test, but he didn't actually wound himself, which I think was pretty funny. But now he's vulnerable, and honestly, I really don't want to put him in the other Raider unit, which is sort of dwindling in number. Speaking of that one, that un other unit ran into the forest so that the lead belchers would have a harder time shooting at them. They would be hitting on sixes because they were shooting at a skirmisher unit in the forest. So I felt pretty safe. However, I did abandon my Hearthstone. Although I was rolling really well for channeling, I was getting at least one channel almost every turn, so I didn't really need the extra power dice, and I didn't have a lot of spells to cast. And with the ca his caster dead, I didn't really need the to be in range of the Hearthstone. Otherwise, the gores in over on the right there kept fighting the iron guts. They were doing a couple wounds. I think at this point there's only two or three iron guts left, along with the general. But I am losing a lot of gores, but they are steadfast, so they're hanging out. So this is a couple turns afterwards. The bulls up in the corner, you can't see it, but they did actually rally. And but he needed the double ones, and he got them. And he had some knoblars in the flank of the minotaurs there, so to hold up the minotaur unit while he could run away with his bulls, which I thought was a really good move. Although I was sort of excited to have the minotaurs just chomp through knoblars because that would just give them more attacks the longer the combat went. He charged in with his lead belchers here in the center. He charged the Ungor Raiders, who, like an idiot, I faced them the wrong way, so I couldn't stand and shoot. Not that that would have done anything, but it was a pretty wacky combat. He didn't do any wounds at all with his lead belchers. Actually, I think he might have killed one raider. But I was in the poison thicket, and so my raiders attacked. I did one wound with my Bray Shaman. My raiders attacked and rolled double sixes to hit. So that was two poison wounds. He failed all of his armor saves and actually lost an ogre. So his bellower turned around and fled from the raiders along with the wizards, which I thought was pretty hilarious. The other lead belchers ran into one of the buildings in the corner there. So I just turned around with the gore unit to come support this flank because this gore unit in the center here is about to get obliterated. Here's a little funny occurrence. Another example of insane courage that my opponent kept rolling. I needed to kill this one Knoblar in my turn. I killed the whole unit down to one model, but they were steadfast, and their leadership ten general was right next to them. Well, not next to them, but with nearby. So they kept making their steadfast rolls, and I cut the unit down to one model. And I figured that he would run because he needed double ones because he was out of the general's range and not steadfast anymore. And he rolled the double ones and he held in combat with only one Knoblar fighting four Minotaurs, which was insane. And so that pretty much took the Knoblars out of the game because this was, I think, turn four or five at this point, and then the Minotaurs wouldn't be able to maneuver to get into combat, which was so unfortunate. So again, here's a couple turns later. The Gore unit that was fighting the Iron Guts did eventually get wiped out, and the general overran, but I had killed the entire Iron Gut unit eventually, so he didn't really have anything to do. The Lead Belcher is over there was the one that got broken by the wizards, and he's sort of hanging out. He doesn't have anything to do because he hasn't reloaded. And my opponent's Gorger finally came in turn four or five and kept failing. Apparently, Gorgers are required to charge, but they don't have frenzy, which is insane. So what happened was that the Gorger kept declaring charges on the Gore units and things. It kept failing, kept rolling three or four for the charge range, which was really unfortunate, and just stayed in the corner there. And these Gores came around and attacked it, and I got Wizened Wild Form off on them, and they just completely destroyed it in one round of combat, no contest. However, this is, I think, the end of turn five or six, and I mean, I was basically trying to get as many points out of this as I could because I had lost a Gore unit and a couple other models, and I just needed to get as much as I could. So I charged the Gorger and killed it, but this was pretty much the end of the game. So here it is, the last photo of the game. The general came around to try to kill some of the wizards and the Ungors and things, but they ran behind the Minotaurs. The Minotaurs came around to sort of shield them from the Lead Belchers, who got out of their building. But that was the end of turn five, and then my opponent decided that turn six he had absolutely nothing to do, so he sat his guys there, and that was the end of the game. Points came down. It was a relatively close. It was a difference of 200 or 300 points, I think. He killed almost all of the Ungor raiders as well as the Gores and captured their banner and things like that, and I'd killed both his battle standard, his butcher, his bulls, and his iron guts and his gorger. So I was up at I think 800 or 900 points, and he was at 400. Okay, maybe that's not much of a close game, but that was it there. Stuff you think he could have done better? Putting his guys in the woods was a big mistake. I think he could have played more defensively. He had some magic in the beginning there that could have hurt me, but he really didn't use it. So staying back did not would have helped him a little bit more, because if he could have drawn my guys into that forest, I would have lost steadfast and all sorts of things. But I eventually I stopped him from using steadfast instead, which is sort of the other way around, because you don't really expect ogres to be steadfast. But yeah, I definitely think putting the bulls in the forest was the biggest mistake of the game. So I hope you enjoyed this game. I should have more coming up. I hope hopefully I remember to bring my camera to more games. I'd also like to do some 40K matches, some more 40K matches, because I did just finish up a Tau Empire army that I would like to play some games with and show that to you guys. So stay tuned. Out.